Welcome students, first of all, good morning all of you. I am Professor J.D. Patil, Assistant Professor, Department of Processing and Food Engineering, KKO College of Agriculture, Engineering and Technology, Nashik. Today we will discuss about effects of thermal and gaseous environment on livestock. So before that point, this is important term, animal environment interactions. This is important. Livestock. The livestock lie within an environment complicated by a multitude of factors, including both physical and psychological aspects of animal surroundings. The thermal environment has a strong influence on farm animals, with the air temperature having the primary effect, but altered by wind, precipitation, humidity, and radiation also. Ideally, the impact of thermal environment can be described in terms of effective ambient temperature, which combines the various climatic events. The animals compensate within limits for variation in effective ambient temperature by altering food intake, metabolism, and heat dissipation, which in turn alter the partition of dietary energy by the animals. The net result is an altered energetic efficiency, which can require dietary changes in nutrient to energy ratios in animal. Okay. The thermal balance. The important term in thermal balance is homeothermic. So homeothermic means generally animals maintain relatively constant core temperature by balancing heat gain from metabolism against that gained from or given up to the environment. Okay, so this is important as per the subject point of view, homeothermic. The homeothermic animals maintain relatively constant body temperature by balancing heat gain from metabolism against that gain from or given up to the environment. But this heat balance is achieved through the concert effects of physiological, morphological, and behavior thermoregulatory mechanisms. Okay, generally observed by Montinth 1974 and Robert Shaw 1974. Too rapid rate of heat loss leads to hypothermia, also too slow loss, slow that time loss to hypothermia. Okay, so neither can be tolerated for an extended time. Under most conditions, there is a continual net loss of sensible heat from body surface through conduction, convection, and radiations. And under all conditions, there is continuous loss of insensible evaporative heat from respiratory tract and skin surface. Also, net rate of heat loss generally depends on thermal demand of surroundings, environment, and resistance to heat flow of the tissue, skin, and its cover. This environmental heat demand is a function of meteorological factors and reflects the cooling power of the surrounding. And at the time of environmental temperature exceeds body temperature, okay, animals may gain net heat from environment, but then expend energy to rid themselves of heat via evaporation. The environmental heat demand equals the rate of heat flow from an animal to a particular environment. The first important factor influence means effect on livestock, thermal radiations. So generally thermal radiation received by animal has two primary sources, solar radiations directly or reflected from clouds and surrounding surfaces, and terrestrial or long wave radiation generally emitted from all surfaces constituting the surroundings. The net impact of thermal radiations on an animal depends on difference between combined solar and long wave radiation received and long wave radiation emitted by the animal. The sheds, nearby structures and other animals, ground cover, clouds, surface characteristics of the animal, and insulation along with interior surface of housing are examples of factors influencing the net impact of thermal radiation. For animals in sunlight, a net gain of heat by thermal radiation usually exists, resulting in an increase of 3 to 5 degree. Okay, in winter the increase it is beneficial. Okay, in summer it is detrimental. Okay. Then second factor, humidity. The air moisture content influences an animal's heat balance, particularly in warm or hot environments where evaporative heat loss is crucial to homeothermy. Higher the ambient vapor pressure, lower the vapor pressure gradient from the skin or respiratory tract to the air, and hence the lower the rate of evaporation. Okay, an increase in ambient vapor pressure generally has less impact on heat balance of species that depend more on panting, okay, and less on sweating, okay, to lose heat during heat stress. Hence, different weighing are given dry bulb and wet bulb temperatures in calculating temperature humidity indices for different species. The third important factor also air movement. The air movement in livestock buildings affects rate of convective and evaporative heat exchange. Here, the magnitude of this effect is moderated somewhat by reduction in skin temperature because husk constriction reduces animal environmental temperature gradient. Okay, the increase in rate of heat loss or gain per unit increase in air velocity is greatest at lower air velocities because disruption of the boundary layer of still air surrounding the body requires relatively little air movement. The above 6 km per hour increase air velocity results in little additional increase in convective heat transfer by means of wind. Index, the combined effect of ambient temperature and air speed on environment heat demand is represented by a single value. The conduction, convection, radiation, evaporation. Okay, the generally three sources of heat loss, heat transfer. On the basis of conduction, heat transfer involving two objects in physical contact with each other. Then convection, heat transfer between solid and liquid or gaseous state, and radiation, generally heat transfer between two substances that are not in contact, means no medium used for radiation heat transfer. Also, evaporation means generally loss of heat due to liquid water phase changing into gaseous water. Okay. The heat transfer between animals and their environments. In addition to making heat metabolically, animals exchange heat with their environments by conduction, convection, evaporation, and thermal radiations. An animal body temperature depends on heat gains and losses. It is constant only if the sum total of gains equals the sum total of losses. The conduction and convection have in common the property that when heat moves through material substance by the mechanism, the atoms and molecules of the substance participate in the transfer of heat. Conduction occurs when a material substance is macroscopically motionless. Okay, and also in convection is heat transfer brought about by flow of material substances, example by wind. Convection is much faster than conduction. The evaporation is a potentially potent mechanism for heat transfer because change of state of water from liquid to gas absorbs a great deal of heat per gram of water. The heat is absorbed from the surface where evaporation occurs and is carried away with the water vapors. Also, thermal radiation, generally heat transfer occur by means of beams of radiant energy that all objects emit and that travel between objects at the speed of light, okay, in the form of wavelength. Because of thermal radiation heat transfer, objects can exchange heat at a distance. So this is the figure, shows a direct radiation from sun and sky, okay, means that time heat gain by animals, also reflected radiation from trees, cells. At that time, heat gained by animals. Also, heat gained from ground or other sources through conduction. Also, radiation reflected off the ground. Yes, so these are heat gaining sources. Also, heat loss from the skin surfaces through circulating air cools using convection process. Also, cause radiated heat to the sky, particularly at the night. Also, heat loss from lungs via evaporation, heat loss by sweat evaporating, also heat transfer to the ground via conduction, also cause radiant heat to the ground. Okay, so these are heat loss. The this figure shows generally air temperature at 30 degrees Celsius and air temperature at 40 degrees Celsius. Okay, so that time heat loss through conduction, convection, and radiation. The heat loss by conduction, convection, radiation all depend on temperature difference between cow and the surrounding environment. Okay. Also, a temperature at 40 degrees Celsius, that time was the air temperature exceeds the cow's body temperature. That time heat loss can only occur by evaporation. The body temperature exceeds the temperature just a shell, okay, exceed a shell. So that time heat loss can only occur by evaporation. Okay, by breathe evaporation also. Operating by sweating, okay. The rate that conduction between an organism and its surrounding correlates to the surface area of contact, the difference in temperature and specific heats of organism and surroundings. Also, convection acts similarly to conduction in that if the rate relies on the surface area, temperature difference and specific heat. Also, rate that radiation occurs depends solely on the surface area and temperature. And also, evaporation occurs when the body uses heat to cause phase changes between liquid water and gaseous water on the skin. As it requires heat to be extracted from body, evaporation may only lead to heat loss. Okay, thank you, students.